So what I am showing you right now is nothing new, but how to open a test case. If you have already done a test case, you would have saved it at some place. So you are opening that in Selenium IDE. So you go File, and then you go Open, and then you can navigate to the folder where you have saved it. And let's say I want to open one of the test cases. So this is the test case that I have opened. Now, you can, looking into this, these are the commands that can give you some idea of what probably is happening in here. What is happening here is we are testing this website, something called Buckaroo website. You will be opening that website. Now, notice from the previous class to this class, we have something different in here. This is some extra thing. So this is what it would have been recorded at the time of recording. So we are opening that site. We are clicking and waiting on something called, this is like, you know, some CTL button and all that. Then we are typing in the username. This is QA Online Trainer. Then in the password, we are typing the password. And we click and wait. And there's something new here called assert text. Assert text. So let's discuss what is this assert text. Now, before I get into assert text and all that, let me just quickly run this to show you what we are doing, and I'll run it a bit slow so that you can see what exactly is happening. So it should technically go and then open my browser, and at this point, so it is almost going to do that, and it might be doing here in the background without us even paying attention to it. So so all that happened without the looked into it. So let me just do it one more time. So let's say we were at Google, right? And I want to go ahead and I want to run this. When I let me just minimize it so that we can see what is happening in the background. So here it is, and I will go and I will run this and keep an eye on the browser. So it navigates and takes me to that Buckaroo thing. And then from there, it is doing whatever it is supposed to do. All right? So, okay. Now, there is that the test, if you look into it, the test did pass. The test did pass, right? So, now, all this time in previous class, I have shown you what I did. But here, I did not even discuss, and I just opened a test case, and I'm looking at these things, and then you, I'm expecting you to understand what happened here. Well, I don't want to make it difficult on you that you should understand what happened here. So let me just quickly go and then walk you through what exactly happened here. Basically, open a site, click and wait on some button. So if I go back in here, so it is, now you would say that, where is this? Where is this? Where did it click on that, right? Where did it click on that? So any element, if you need to identify, you highlight that and then do find, click on find. So if you see and click on find here, if you see here, that's where it is flashing. So that means that this element, click and wait, it is basically this place it is going to click. It clicked on that, right? It clicked on that. And then we said type something. So if you say type find, it is unable to find, because basically it has come to a different page now. So it started off here. It started off here. So now if I go ahead and then bring it up and say this one, if I say find, it finds that. Now click and wait on, and if I say find, so that means that, okay, it was now type and find. So type where? It is typing in this. And then type and find, it is typing in the password. So now you say click and wait. Where is it going to click? It is going to click on this, right? So that's what it did. So if I, and then after that, we said assert here, right? So this, at this point, it would have gone to the next page. So in the next page, we will see where we are asserting. So first of all, we need to find out what is the meaning of assert and how does it assert. So if I run it one more time, it is going to do the following and then there it is. It does that, clicks on that, and then assert this text. So where it is asserting, I don't know if you look into this part, because after assert, we one more time we clicked and wait. So if I don't want to run this click and wait, I will just delete so that we can just see where this assert is. So one more time, if I run, let's see what happens in here. It goes to the main page, enters that, clicks on the sign in, and now it passed, and we want to see where it asserted, right? So if I click on find, you notice that this portion is highlighted. So that's where the assert text. So now let's talk about what is an assert. So what is this command? What do you mean by assert? Basically, what happens is if you want to find out when you log in, if you successfully logged in or not. So according to this application, whatever email address you use, it will say welcome, and then it will say the same email address. So if the email address exists there, that means that your test passed. If you type something else, then it will not exist in here. So that means that your test failed. So how can we make sure that the test pass? We want to give a command called either verify that this text is here or assert this text is here. So what is the difference between verify and assert, right? And how do we actually do it? So for that, I will go and do a similar test, but a different test. The one which you have used as your assignment, as your homework, that's what I'm going to do. Meaning that, okay, here I go, and let's say if I go in here and do a QA online trainer @gmail.com, and the password, let's say, is password. If I do that, now notice it said sign in as that, right? It said sign in as that. So if I see sign in as that, that means that it is good, right? Let's say if I sign out from here, and if I go and then do this QA online trainer and gmail.com, and password is password. And if I do this, of course, I don't see anything in here. That means that it was not able to log in, right? So this means that this test failed, let's say. So test is only passed if you log in, right? Let's say test pass if you log in, otherwise the test would fail. So how can you make sure that you have successfully logged in? How can you do that? So for that, we will go ahead and then we will see how to make sure that we do that. So for that, if I go in here and type the right password and click on that, now I logged in, right? Now I have to verify that this is there. This is there. And the way I verify is I highlight that, right click, and I would say, after I right click, I would say that I need to see that this thing is there. So while I am recording, I will right click. Right now I'm not recording. While I'm recording, I will right click on it. And then when I right click on it, it will say, commands. It will say show all commands. And once I show all commands, we will see the commands like verify and assert and all that. All right. So let me go and then do the recording right now. So to do the recording, I will bring up my Selenium IDE, right? And here I am going to do the recording. So this is already in the record mode. And the name of the website is screencast. So I'm just going to go and then do screencast. Now I will start to record. And in the recording here, I will go and then I will type let's say the email address, which is QA online trainer, and let's say 9@gmail.com, and I would say password. Right. Okay, now notice it did not log in. It did not log in, right? So at least I will go in here and I will see what is my test case. I will stop it now and I will see my test case. So this is my open, type this, type the password and click and wait, right? Okay, so if I go ahead and if I run this again, it will duplicate what the actions which I have performed manually. So it goes in there, takes me there, types that QA online, clicks on that, and of course it is not a valid one. So if you see here, I made a mistake here, not made a mistake, I intentionally did it so that I could show you how you can go and edit it. So if I go in here and if I edit it and if I do this and if I run this test again, now notice what happens. It goes in and it clicks on that and it is logging in, right? It logged in. Now I want to verify that this text is there. I want to verify that this text is there. And the way I can do that is, even though the test has completed running, I will come in here and I will do some more recording. So I will go in here and I will record. What I will record? Okay, let's see. I click on that and I want to record the following. I highlighted this and I right click on that. And notice when I right click, it came back and it said, here, assert text, verify text, right? And then it says show all available commands, right? And in these show all available commands, we have so many other commands, right? What you can see, so many other commands in here. So what we will do in here is we will just talk about assert and verify and store. So what is assert text? What do you mean by assert text? Assert text means that, you know, at this point, do I see whatever is written here? Do I see when I run the test? So I will click on that. And I will go back into my recording here and I will stop. So if you see here, what did we recorded here? Assert text that signed in as QA that is there, right? So I will log out of it and I will run it one more time and see if it is going to assert it. So I will come in here and I will run it. So it goes in there, it types that, clicks on that, and then make sure that it runs, and then you have it. Because it reads for this one. Do we find here? Yes, we found this one. So it's a pass. If I make some changes, if I come in here and if I call this email address as QA online trainer 1, let's say, or 3, right? And if I run it right now, let's see what will happen. If I run this, so first of all, it's going to I'll log out from here, and let's say we are at some other place like Google, and let me just run it now. So here I go. So it is going to take me there. Type that, and now notice that it is looking for this. It is looking for, do I have QA online here? No, I don't have. So the test, it will fail the test, right? So assert text, assert is to make sure that whatever you want at an element, if that is there or not. So it is basically used to check if a certain value does exist there or not. If I want to assert and make sure that this blog is there or this pricing is there, I can do that. So how do? I just highlight it while recording. I highlight it and right click on that and say assert text. Now, what's the difference between assert text and verify text? The difference is verify means that, again, it will look for the same thing, and if it fails, if it doesn't find it, it'll fail the test. But if there are something more here to do, it will continue to do that. Now you would say, what more can be there? So let's say there is something like forgot password, right? Forgot password. So if you want to do the recording of this, so I will do this and I will do the recording here. Forgot password, right? And I will put in the email address there, QA online trainer. I don't know which one I had used here. One second. I had used 3. So I would say QA online trainer 3 at gmail.com. All right. And I will do a send. Right. And after I do a send, notice it says this, sorry, we cannot find the email address QA online trainer 3. So meaning it is not even there, but that's fine. That's fine because I want to show you the difference between verify and test. So we came in here. So this is continuation, right? This is the continuation of that. So I will stop this. I will stop the test and I will try to run it and show you the difference between verify and assert. So if we have recorded some more new things in here. So if I have assert test, of course, if I go with qaonline3@gmail.com and password, it won't find, so it will fail here. But after failing, will it run the other things or not? That's what we have to see. So if I run now, if I do this, let's see what happens in the browser. It is doing this, doing that, clicking on that, right? And if you see here, that's it. My, you are not able to even see that, but my test is not even continuing. After this point, my test is like it failed and it stopped right here. It did not continue to do anything. Because why? Because I've used the assert test. Now the difference is, had I used here verify text. If I use verify text. Now verify text, it is going to verify for this. Again, it will fail. It won't verify. It will fail, but it will continue to do the rest of the stuff. So let us go and then run it and see what happens. There it is. It's gonna go in there, click on that. It won't find it. And now it stopped. But is it going to continue or not? Is it going to do it, click on the forgot link or not? So now it stopped in here and then it did not continue. Let's see. Remember base URL start recording with an open. It should have continued. So let's see. Let's see if it would do that one more time. Does that? Okay. It stopped here. It is not continuing. It should have continued. Verify text. Hang on for a second. Let us see. So we had things like we have commands like store probably because I have used the text. If I have used anything else, verify text at the CSS verify, assert, verify, I'm just looking into it, store element present. It should have continued. I'll see, maybe some browser settings or something that would have, might have caused it. It should have, let me just see. Record, play the entire, fastest, lower, toggle, set clear, execute this command, edit, select, delete, insert new command, file, properties, of the test. Okay, I'll look into it what happened, but it should have continued the test. It should have continued the test, so it did not continue. But I'll take a look and see. Maybe one of the properties which I might be missing in here. But I'll let you know about that, why it did not continue. But it should continue, and it should do that. That's the difference between the assert and verify of the test. Okay, so now you have your IDE. Now we have to take you to the next step, because let's say if the test fail, then I want to do something else. At this point, when the test fails, let's say, we want to go back again, and then we want to do something like change this to the right email address, which is QA trainer at gmail.com, or whatever is the valid email address we need to change and do things. So for that, your IDE will not basically be able to do things like that. For that, we have to get into the actual tool that can do it. So in Selenium, as we have been talking about all this time, in Selenium, there are three versions of or modes of Selenium. So we looked into the IDE portion of it, but the IDE portion is not over yet, right? Because we will be coming back to IDE again and again for some help. And what kind of help are you going to get from IDE? Basically, the kind of help which you get out of IDE is, for those of you folks who are, let's say, not well-versed with coding, right? We don't know programming, and we don't know Java programming. We don't know any programming. So you can still get a lot of help from IDE, because IDE, there is a trick in IDE that will convert all these instructions, whatever these instructions are there, it will convert it into code. It will convert it into code. And for you to convert this instructions into code, basically what you have to do is you have to go into options, and in the options you have to go into one more options, right? So options, and here you got to make sure that this enable experimental features, what you see here, enable experimental features, it should be checked like that, right? So you got to make sure that that is checked. Once you make sure that enable experimental feature is checked, right, then if you want the IDE to convert whatever we have done in here, convert this into Java code, you can go into options, and you can go into this format. And in format, if you see something like what you're seeing here, that means that IDE is able to convert it into any code. Like what code it can convert it into? It can convert into Java code. It can convert into, as you can see, convert into Python. It can convert into Ruby. Now, if you recall, I did mention that I will not be covering this Ruby, Python, and C# and all that. We will just be doing the Java part of it. All right. Okay. So since using Java as the language, we can use either Web Driver or Remote Control, which is RC Server. So since our next topic is going to be Web Driver, so I at least want to see what kind of code we will be writing if we have to do the Web Driver testing. So the code we want to write to do the Web Driver testing, for that we have to basically go into Eclipse. So we have to go into Eclipse, like you can see here. I'm going into Eclipse, and then I will start Eclipse, and then I will write that code. Now you would say that on my machine, I don't have Eclipse. If that's what you are saying, then I would say that, okay, that's a part of preparation of your environment, meaning that your machine should be having Eclipse on it. You should download Eclipse, and you should install Eclipse. Now, to download Eclipse, you will be going to, let's say you go to Google, and then you type in Google, download Eclipse. When you say download Eclipse in Google, you will come across so many websites or the links here. So the first one is fine. Click on the Eclipse download. When you click on that, it takes you to this site. And this is the place from where you can download Eclipse. Okay. Now, why are we downloading Eclipse? What is Eclipse? Basically, Eclipse is nothing but it's a tool. If you want to create your resume, where do you go to create your resume? You'll say that we usually go to Microsoft Word, and that's where you create your resume. That is exactly right, because Microsoft Word is a tool, right? It'll help you to create some documents, and resume is a document. Now, if you want to do a web service or web service, if you want to do your testing, your Selenium testing, and Selenium testing using Web Driver, where would you go to write that code or to do the testing? You must go to a tool called Eclipse. So how do you get Microsoft Word on your machine? You will buy that software and then you would install that software on your machine, right? Likewise, for Eclipse, you don't have to buy it. It comes free. So why there are free software? There is something called open source. Open source means that some smart people, they want to, be creative. So they try to help the world. So they will come up with some good softwares and then they will give it out for free so that others can use and benefit out of it. And then some companies basically create these tools and then they will sell the tools. If you sell anything, that becomes a commercial license you need for that because you have to pay because it's being used for commercial purpose. So Microsoft Word, Excel and all that, these are all commercial tools. So you have to pay for it. Eclipse is not a commercial tool. It is a free tool because some smart people, they put their time into it and effort into it and they create it. And so the rest of the world is using it. So we want to go ahead and then use this. So when you go and use this over here to download, we came in here. There are multiple versions of Eclipse, if you can see here. There is Eclipse Standard. There is Eclipse Standard. There is Eclipse IDE for that. There is Eclipse IDE for Java programmers. There is Eclipse IDE for that. And if you scroll down, you will notice that there is also Eclipse for testers. Right. So if you go further down here, there is Eclipse for testers. Here. Eclipse for testers. Now you can download this Eclipse for testers, and you have to look into whether your machine is a 32-bit or 64-bit. Now to make sure what is your machine, you will click on this start. You will click on control panel, and then you will depending on whether you have like that or whether you have small icons, whether you have large icons, right? So you go here and then you go into system. When you go into system, it will show you basically what your machine is, if your machine is 32-bit or 64-bit. So my machine is 64-bit. That's what most of the newer machines are. Basically, it depends on the operating system, right? What operating system you have installed. So I have installed Windows 7 Ultimate, and that is a 64-bit operating system. If you have a Windows XP, in XP it comes in both 32-bit as well as 64-bit. So just take a look which is yours, and once you know from here which is yours, then basically you could go and then download that particular 32-bit or 64-bit. But again, which one? Can you do Eclipse for testers? You can do Eclipse for testers. But what I want you to do is, I want you to go ahead and then download this Eclipse IDE for a Java enterprise developer. You would say that I'm not a developer, I'm a tester, so I should download. So that's fine. You can download that as well. But this is much better. It's free. It can do everything. Maybe chances are in 6 months from now when you want to do some advanced stuff at that time, this software is not enough for you, Eclipse for testers. So at that time, you have to go and then you have to download this. So why not right now? So that's why we will go ahead and then download it. Now, what's the difference between the Indigo and Eclipse Kepler? The names here, what you see here, like if you see here, Eclipse Kepler, and mine is when I installed it, when I downloaded it, it was called. Let me just show it to you. Mine. this is mine, right? So when I start, see here, Indigo, right? Mine is Indigo. One more time, if you see here, it is Indigo. Now that's a slightly different flavor. That is, I mean, there's not huge difference. The newer version, which you see here, is this Kepler, Eclipse Kepler. So not much of a difference. So either one is fine. So you can go and download this. So let's say if I download this, if I click on Windows 64, now here it is. It'll take you to the next page, and in the next page, there it will say, okay, where do you want to download it? Some of you guys are from London, UK. So you might see something different there. Depending on where you live, it might show you something different here. So most of us are here in the United States and Canada. So you should be able to download from here. So you click on that, and then it says that okay, it is downloading. If you see here, it is downloading. Eclipse Kepler version is downloading right now. Now, if you have difficulty, if let's say after downloading, I'll show it to you how to do the installation. And if you find that there's a difficulty and this is not behaving the way you want it to be, like exactly like mine, then you do this. When you log into your account, let me just do this. When you log into your account, I am not showing you. When you log into your account, basically, you all must have access to this artifacts to download. If you don't, let me just give you access to it right now. One second, bear with me. You all should be seeing one second. The difference between assert and verify text is verify text will continue the test even if it cannot verify. Assert will stop right there. So assert will fail the test and not do any other thing after that. One second, let me just bear with me for a minute here. I'm just trying to give you the access to all your now majority of you have access to those folders. If you don't, then that's why. Okay, if you check your emails right now, you all should have access to that folder. So in this folder, in this artifacts to download, in this folder, I have the Eclipse. See here, this is the Eclipse. So this is the Indigo. If you need to use that, just click on it, and you could download from here. So this is the Indigo. You could download from here. You will get the Indigo because online, I don't think they have Indigo anymore, because right now, once you download, you will see that Kepler. And you know, they are asking you to donate some money, so it is up to you if you want to donate that. So occasionally I donate them, because I use their software, and you know, I use it for the commercial purpose, meaning that I'm teaching, and then I'm training students, and I'm making some money out of it. So occasionally, here and there, I give them some money. So it's up to you if you want to give them $5. If you find that Eclipse, if not right away, once you get your job, and if you find that okay, they have that this tool had helped you in getting a job, you just give them $5-$10. I think it is it makes sense. The question is, can I use the Eclipse Kepler? Absolutely, you can. Now, in fact, I'm going to be showing you both. So this is, I just started that, right? I started it and I showed you the Indigo. So what I will do is, I just downloaded this. So I will go into the show all, or let me see, open the containing folder. So if I open the containing folder, I will take this. I will take this. If you see here, I will cut from here, and I will go to my Selenium. I'll go to my Selenium folder. In my Selenium folder, I'll go to all jars, or not to all jars, because it's not a jar file. So what I will do is, one second, I will go into Selenium download, and I will paste it here. I'll paste it here. So if you see, the last time I downloaded in the year 2003, showing to one of the in the class in the month of May of I downloaded Juno, right? I downloaded Juno. Now I downloaded this Kepler. So, and before that, in the year 2011, we downloaded that. So any version is fine. So it, let's say this one, because this is what you will get from the internet. And the one which I showed you, you will get it from my site, which is I already showed you that you could go and then you could download this, right? So it is up to you, whichever you want to download. It's up to you. All right. So once you download, there is nothing like an installation when it comes to open source softwares. There is nothing like an installation. What basically happens is you will be unzipping this software. So let me see if I can unzip it. So I will do that, double click on it. So if you have a Windows WinZip utility, that will open up, and it is saying that okay, I am going to extract it. So when you click on extract, it is asking you, where do you want to extract? So it is saying that in C drive, there's a Selenium download, and this is a folder. It will extract it into this folder. If you want to rename it, you can rename this folder and create a new folder and rename it. So let's say if I go and do this, right, new folder. So new folder, I want to call it Kepler, right? So, let's say Kepler, right? So I want to install it in that Kepler folder, right? So because it was like 270 megs, so it is going to go and then process and then install it. So once it unzip and then put everything in there, what you see is something like this. So in here, if you see, this is the Eclipse. So this is what we have to use every time. So if you want to start Eclipse every time, you don't have to go from C drive into Selenium. In Selenium, you are looking into Selenium download, and then you are looking into this Eclipse, and then you're looking. You don't have to do all that. So what you can do is just create a shortcut. Right click on that and say create a shortcut. And when it creates a shortcut, like this, put this shortcut in here on your desktop, anywhere on your desktop, right? So I can say that this I can rename, right click on that, and I can rename, and I can say that this is my Indigo, right? This is my Indigo. I'm using it for Selenium, right? So Indigo for Selenium. Now let's say if I go back and I try to do, let me go into Selenium download, and let me do, if you see in the Kepler, because we were doing the unzipping it into Kepler. So if I go into Kepler, inside Kepler, I have Eclipse again, and I have this one, right? So what should I do now? This is exactly what you will be seeing. So you right click on that, you create a shortcut. The shortcut is here. So that shortcut, you put it in, you put it in your desktop. So this is my shortcut. I put it in my desktop. And in the desktop here, Eclipse shortcut, I will rename it as this is what Kepler, right? So this is nothing but a different version Kepler. So this is going to be brand new. This is brand new. There is nothing in it. This I already was using it, but this is brand new. There is nothing in it. So let me just use it and show it to you. So once I double click on that, there it is, the Kepler, right? Eclipse Kepler. So it is going to open, and the first thing that it is going to ask me is select a workspace. See here, select a workspace. So it points to, every machine will have users, and this is how I log into my machine called Trainer. In your case, if your name is John, it will say users John. If your name is Jane, it will say users Jane, / workspace. Now you don't really have to point it there. You can create your workspace. Workspace means that whatever we will be doing, all that code will be saved in this folder. So you can create it in your C drive. So you can quickly go to your C drive, in your C drive. And in C drive, you just create a folder. So here is my new folder. I will call it Selenium Workspace. Right? Selenium Workspace. There's already one like that from before. So let me just call it Selenium Training Workspace. Right? Okay. So I created a workspace. If you go in, there is nothing in here. See that? Empty. So I have to select that workspace. So I browse, and I will go to my C drive, right? So go into my computer, my C drive, and in my C drive, I will be going into Selenium, right? Selenium Training Workspace. So this is the one, Selenium Training Workspace. So I will select that. So I will select that, and I will hit OK. Now, once I do that, what it is going to do right now is it is going to open my Eclipse, and with this Eclipse I should be able to do certain things. What can I do in here? If you see, let me make the screen bigger, and if you see here, very first time it comes back and says that this is the welcome screen here, right? It's the welcome screen. It says okay, so what do you want to do? Do you want to see some tutorials? Do you want to see what's new in here? Do you want to see this? So it is basically asking you, what do you want to do? So what you do is you just basically X out of it, right? Okay, now if you see here, this is where we will be spending a lot of our time in this course. So since we are going to spend a lot of time in our course doing this, so you have to have an idea of what this tool is all about, right? So you have to have an idea of what this tool is all about. So that's what we will be looking into right now, like what this tool is all about. So in order to do that, let me just take it a little bit slow and then go over again. These basically the menu items, right? Now, many a times I will be going in here and doing these things. So you'll find me using menu a lot, right? You'll find me using the menu items a lot. So so that is something that we will be using a lot. Then we have this is the tool. This is the tool toolbar. So depending on what I am doing, I will see a different toolbar. Meaning that right now, if you see something, you see that there's something there. This is to run. There's so many things. But if I'm doing something else, then it might, these things will go away. So this behaves based on where I am and what I am doing right now, right? So sometimes these things will not be there. Sometimes these things. So it depends on many, many things. Okay, let's look into the most important thing that you have to look into. And that is called, what is the purpose of using this Eclipse? So that is done here. If you see here Java EE, that means that that's bad. So you say, why is it bad? Why EE is bad? Java EE is bad. The reason Java EE is bad is because I do not want to use this for development or Java Enterprise Edition development. I want to use it for testing. So it should be. This is called a perspective. Perspective. So you are using this tool for the perspective of Java. So you click on this square grid button, and then from here, make sure that you select Java. Make sure that you select just the Java. Right? Now this step is very important. Now notice how everything changed here. No, because we have to be, even though it is showing Java Enterprise Edition, you have to be always be selecting Java. Always be selecting Java. Now that you have Java in there, so that means that we are looking into the Java perspective. Now you're looking into Java perspective. This task list is not important, so you can X out. Outline not important, you can X out. Now in the bottom here, you can just X out of these things for now, right? Now take a look. We have two parts right now here. We have the right hand side, we have this right hand side empty part, and we have on the left side, you see something called a package explorer, right? Package explorer. I am not interested in package explorer. Now you would say that, what are you interested in, right? You're not interested in Java Enterprise Edition, you're not interested in package explorer. What are you interested in? So we would go into the window and we say show view, right? And if you see here, I am interested in Project Explorer. So there's a difference between Package Explorer and Project Explorer. I should be seeing Project Explorer, right? And once I see Project Explorer, I don't need this Package Explorer, so I can close it, and I should be seeing what? Yeah. Project Explorer. So in the Project Explorer, we, as the name goes, we will be creating some projects, right? We'll be creating some projects. So what projects would you be creating? Well, we will be creating some testing projects, right? So this is how things work. Now that you have Eclipse installed on your machine, we will go ahead and we will talk a little bit about what are the things which you should be looking into right now. The things which you should be looking into right now is, I have on my machine, I have, this is you saying that, Selenium comes as IDE. I have already installed it and I already know how to work with it. Maybe not 100%, but you know how to work with it. Okay, good. Now, we also know that there is Selenium RC server, and then there is Selenium Web Driver, right? Now, for Selenium IDE, we needed Firefox, right? Because it was the plugin of Firefox. So I already showed you. For these two, you need to have Eclipse, right? And in Eclipse, at least you know that there are versions like Indigo and Kepler, right? And many other. I mean, if you see here, I had something called Juno, right? You have used, I have something called Juno, right? These are not important. The difference between Indigo, Kepler, and Juno is, these are, as time goes, they came up with a newer version. So this was here actually. And then they came up with the Kepler. Kepler is the latest one right now, right? So there's not much of a difference. If there's a difference, I'll let you know. So we already saw as how to install it. Installation was already done. Download and extract and get a shortcut. And that will open, and we did all that. Now we will see how to use it. Now, once I know how to use it, I can use it for web driver and I can use it for RC server. Alright. Now, for the RC server and web driver, I need to know, because I have to create a script. I have to create script. And which language can I use for that? I will be using Java. So very soon you will find how to use, basically in how to use, I will be using it for RC or web driver, and I will be basically writing some scripts in Java, right? Okay, now that you have some idea of it, let us see how we write those scripts. So in Eclipse, number one, you have to create a project. You have to create a project. That's why I told you to open the project explorer. You have to create a project. Number two, you have to do what? While creating the project, there are some steps that you have to follow. Then after that, you have to create a class. Now you would say that I don't know anything about how to create a project, how to create it. Of course you don't know. I know that you don't know. That's why you are here. That's why you paid me. Because I have to show you, right? And after I show you, you will know, right? So creating a class again would have some steps in there. And then finally, we will be creating our code or script, right? Inside the class, right? So the main purpose is to create the script or code or the script. But where can we do it? We can do it only inside the class. And the class is inside the project. And the project is inside Eclipse. So that's why we had to download Eclipse and do that. Can we use some other tool for Selenium? Of course, you can use some other tool. So that tool can be like IDEA, or that can be like some other couple of other tools. But the most popular tool is this Eclipse, right? So that's what we'll be using, the Eclipse. Okay, so now with that introduction, we are here in Eclipse, all right? Now, which version of Eclipse it is, if you go into About, it will tell you that this is the Kepler version of Eclipse, right? Okay, good. Now, according to this, if I want to do automation, I have to create a project, create a class, and then have my code inside. Now, I have zero knowledge of coding, right? I have zero knowledge of coding. Can I still do automation? Answer is yes, you can do automation even with zero knowledge of coding. Why? Because from zero to become a hero, you are here, right? So hopefully you will become a hero, right? Very soon. As far as coding is concerned, because you will be learning a lot of it in the upcoming classes. So let's create this structure so that you become very familiar as how to do it. So coming here, I have to start a project. So how do you start a project? Easy. You will go into File and you say that new Java project, right? Java project. Because we have to create what is called a Java project. So I will say Java project. And then it will come here and it will ask you some questions. So if you go back in here, I told you that when you create a project, you have to answer some questions, something here, right? And then it will basically go and create a project. So here we go. We have to answer some questions. What question? What is the name of the project? Well, the name of the project is, if you are working for a company and the name of the company where you are doing the testing for this is, let's say, Verizon, right? Verizon. And this is, I don't know, maybe this is for their accounting software, right? So I will say accounting software, and this is your testing for build number 23. So that could be it. Or if it is a different company, let's say this is I don't know, Citigroup. So Citigroup, and for Citigroup they are in banking and financial. So this is some commercial loan, right? And then you are checking the build, you're testing the build number 3_43, something like that. So that could be the name of the project. So whatever is the name of the project doesn't matter. Just give it a descriptive name, right? That's what we'll be doing. And the next thing after that is, on your machine, if you have, because we opened this as a Java project, right? On your machine, if you have Java installed on your machine. So now you would say that, how would I know if Java is installed on my machine or not? So basically what you do is you go from start, and here in this box, you would type CMD and hit enter. CMD and hit enter. So when you do that, it will bring up this box. And here, to check if Java is there, type Java space minus version, right? So you want to find out if you have Java installed on the machine or not. So you will say Java minus version and hit enter. And if you see something like this, some number, Java version is that means that Java is there. Let's say Java was not there. So let's say this is the real spelling of Java. Just bear with me, because I already have, I cannot show you what the error would be. But let's say this is the real spelling of Java. This is J-A-V-A. And when I do that, it'll come back and say Java is not recognized as internal itself. That means you don't have Java. That means you don't have that. You don't have to type J-A-V-A-A-A-A-A, right? You know why I did that. The reason I did it, because I already have Java, so I cannot show it to you how it will, what would be the command if it is not there. So if I had typed Java and it comes back and says not there, what do you do then? At that time, you would again go back to Google and type download Java, hit enter. Now when you say download Java, it will bring you this link in here, right? You could click on that, and then it will say that free Java download, right? Okay, now there is also another one, I think, this one, second one, right? Yeah, this is a better one. So I can basically give you the URL for that, right? So when you do that, by the way, NetBeans is another tool that you can use in place of Eclipse. If you don't want to use Eclipse, if you want to use NetBeans can also use, right? Okay, so this is Java. You want to download Java. Okay, now a couple of things. Java, right, comes as JRE and it also comes as JDK, right? What's the difference between JRE and JDK? So JRE is the runtime environment or the runtime engine. So basically what happens is there are so many programs that run on Java. So chances are your computer already has Java, because when you are trying to go to some website, that website will only run with Java, so that website would have already downloaded Java on your machine, so you already have Java. So unless and until it's a brand new computer and you don't have Java, then you have to do what I'm showing you. Otherwise, it will be there. Now, JDK is a different story. JDK is a Java development kit. So when you are developing something, even though if it is your scripts, and then you have to download this JDK. So when I clicked on that JDK, it brought me to this page. And if you scroll down a little bit here, it'll tell you what is your operating system. So what are the different operating systems out there today in the year 2014? And there is a Linux, there is a Sun Solaris, there is Mac, and then there is Windows. Of course, we are doing Windows, so you will go into Windows here. And what version of Windows are we doing? 64-bit, or this is x86 means 32-bit. So we are, let's say if you are 64-bit, download this one. See that? Download that one. If it's a 32-bit, download that. So if I click on that, it says that, you have to have, accept the licensing before downloading. So if you see here, I have to click on it and accept the license. And then I can go and I can download this. This is 125. So it is down 125 megabytes. So if you download, it'll take a couple of minutes to download, right? And once you download it, you can just double click on it and then it'll get installed. And after it gets installed, do me a favor, you close this and then open back again and do a CMD and then do a Java hyphen version. And after it installed, it will show you that it has installed and you will see this. You'll see this, right? So that means that Java is installed. So if I take you here, right? So this is JDK. It is it has downloaded. So if I right click on that, open the folder, it will take this JDK from here, and I can cut the JDK, go into my Selenium folder, and just install it there. So there is my Selenium. And Selenium download, and I can paste it and see that's that. And if I double click on that, it'll say run and it'll install it. It says Oracle because Oracle is the company that owns Java, Sun Microsystems. So that's that. Right. So that's Java installation. Okay, so you missed the email. Okay, you are here now. The stuff that you missed, you can watch it in the video. Okay, so now that we have that, so coming back in here, this is what it will show if you already have that. If this was empty, if this was not there, then you have to do whatever I showed you. Otherwise, this will show you that. Okay, now the interview question they might ask you, like, let's say you are going to prepare the environment for our testers. You know, can you walk us through how do you prepare the environment for our testers? And let's say you are the only Selenium guy, and then you have to create a bunch of machines where the other testers can also do Selenium. So how do you prepare the environment? So how do you prepare the environment for testing? First of all, you know, whatever we have done so far, since we will be using IDE, we'll be using Eclipse, and we'll be using, so you will do everything like what I showed you so far. Okay, now that you have named it, and we are not going to do city group, so I will just name it something else. I will call it, let's say Travelocity. And this is reservation testing, right? So Travelocity, we are doing some Travelocity testing. Travelocity testing. So we will go next now. When we do next, now here it is important. Please pay some attention to what I am doing here. See here, you have source, projects, libraries, and order and export, right? Okay, and if right now we are in the source tab, In the source tab, let me just, in the source tab, it is saying that this is the project which you have created, Travelocity, and there is going to be a folder. Inside it, Travelocity, there will be a folder called source. SRC is source. Source. It will create this source. Okay. Now, you don't have to do anything in here. Don't do anything in here. Click on the projects. You are not doing anything here. Libraries is important. Libraries is important. Now, if you expand this, see what do you find in here? These are called jar. So these are Java jar files. Now, what is a jar file? Now, they're not going to ask you this silly question, like what is a jar file? Because, you know, you probably would be claiming 2 to 3 years of experience, and then they know that you have 3 years of experience, so they're probably not going to ask you a basic question like what exactly is a jar file. But think about it. I am going to give you a very, very silly example and analogy here. Very silly. Let's say you are going to make pasta. Right, so you are going to cook pasta, right? So if you're cooking pasta, of course you're going to be putting it on the oven, and then you would like to put in it, let's say some salt, right? And you want to put in it, let's say some pepper, right? So salt is inside a small jar, and pepper is inside a small jar. So each one of the ingredients that you want to put to make that pasta, which is your project now, you will take something from one jar, which is the jar for salt, you'll take something from a jar from pepper, and you take something from another jar, right? So jars are nothing but containers. They contain the things which you will be putting it into the project, right? So here we have all, these are called jar files for Java jar file. So because this is a Java project, we might need so many jar files. You don't really have to worry about, is this pepper, is this like salt, is this, you don't have to worry about that, right? So just notice that all this automatically, Eclipse will take it. It automatically added, it will take it. Now, because these are called Java project, Java jar files, right? Now, if you want to do some testing, right, using Selenium what? Either RC server or web driver, right? If you want to use that, then you have to add those jar files. Those are jar files. Those jar files are... Okay, those jar files are external jar files. So when I click on that, it will take me to a place on your file system, to your C drive, and it is looking for where are those jar files. Now the question is, do you have those Selenium jar files and all that? The answer is no, you don't have them. Why you don't have them? Because you never downloaded them. Now the question is, where are you going to download those jar files? Now, bigger question is, which Selenium jar files do you want to download? Do you want to download the RC server, or do you want to download the web driver? Well, let us see. So you go in here and then into Google, and you would say download Selenium, let's say RC server jar files, something like that. So when you do that, it brings you to this, you click on that. And lo and behold, you came to a place which looks a little bit familiar to us. Why is it familiar? Because 2 days back we were here and then we did something here. We downloaded this 2.5 when we were looking into IDE. Today we'll be looking either into RC server or into this web driver. So if you are looking into RC server or web driver, then you need to download this one. Download this. If you need to download RC server, then you need to download that. If I need to download the web driver, then I need to do something more, like what? If you scroll down, you'll notice that I have to download this. But let us go ahead and let us download this 239. So let me download this 239. What am I downloading? This is the Selenium jar files, right? And you will be surprised that this will work for both, even though it says RC server, it will work for both RC server and web driver. But when I explain you in more details, I will show you the difference between the RC server and the web driver. But for now, you need to download this. So I click on that, right? And it says, okay, you have to download and save this. So Selenium Server standalone 239. So I'm going to save it. So it is downloading, and then once it completes the download, few more seconds left, 33 megabytes. So it is scanning for, and it download, open the container, and I am going to take it from here, cut it from here, and go to my Selenium folder, and in my Selenium folder, if you see here, I have something called all jars. Now, I did not put Eclipse into all jars. I put Eclipse into Selenium download, right? So this is where I put Eclipse into. But when it comes to Selenium, I'm putting in all jars. And if you see here, I will right click and paste it here. Now, if you notice, it is Selenium Server standalone 239. But if you see, there is 25, 28, 215, 2. So this goes back in time. If we were doing something in the year 2011, it was 2.5. If we were doing in the 2011 of October, September, it was 2.5. By October, it became 2.8. By December, it became 2.15. And then the next year, all next year, it went up from 2.15 to maybe there was a 2.16, 2.17, 2.18, but I never downloaded that. Now again, in the year 2000, it became 228, and from starting of the 2013 to starting of the 2014, it came up to 239. So these are all my jar files in time. If I go back in time, these are my jar files, right? Okay, so I come back here, right? And now if I have to add that jar file, so I'm going to click on this external jar file, and I will navigate C drive, and I will navigate to Selenium, and inside Selenium I store it in jar file, and I will scroll till I find that. So here is 239. I will take it, and I save it. And if you see here, it is added here. See here it is added. If I expand, you see that all those things are inside it. Selenium standalone 239. We added that, right? And I will save finish. So by this time, all this time, I just completed this part. I just created the project. I completed this part. Now I have to look into how to create a class. So I come back here again. Now I'm in the project explorer. I have to create a class. So let me expand it. If you see, there is a source folder. There's a jar file for Java. And then this is a jar file for Selenium. All right. Okay, inside this source, I have to create a class. So the way I'm going to be creating a class inside this is, I will say highlight this, and I will either right click on it, right, and say new. New what? Is this a project that I'm going to create? No, this is a class which I'm going to create. So I'll say new class, and then this is a Java class, and this opens up. And if you see here, I said I have to answer some of the questions there, and then this creating of the class will be done. So let's see what kind of questions we have to answer. So this is already, this is going to be our source folder. Then there is something called a package, right? Now, package, you can leave it default. You can leave it default if you are not going to create, let's say, many tests. If you are going to create like one or two tests, you can just leave it as a default because it will just go into the default package. But if you are going to create many tests, then you have to start creating some packages. So as we go in time, as we progress in time, in the future classes, I will start to use packages. Right now, I will skip that. And I come in here in the name of, so here we will put what? The name of this class. So since it's a Travelocity, let's say we are doing a hotel reservation test, right? Hotel reservation test is the name of this class, right? Okay. Now, even though there are so many things in here, I will not touch anything right now, and I will just hit finish. Now, notice what happens, right? If you see here, what happened here is, I will, in the Project Explorer, if you expand, right, there was source, you expand, now it created a default package. In there, it created this class. So now coming back to, I just finished creating this class, right? Okay. Now here comes the most important thing. This is like the soul of everything. This is the most important. This was like, a decision was made to create a body, and this is actually the body was made. Now here is the crux of it. You have to put a soul inside this body, right? And you have to give it some life. And the way you're going to do that is creating a code or script, right? So you come in here. Now inside the class, you have to create some test. Now, what kind of test are we going to do? So I would say that, okay, let us go here. Let us do this. Travelocity.com. Right? I cannot concentrate, so one second. Oh my God. Let's see. It's not even summer. What happened here? I don't know what's going on. So, okay, I am not going to test this. I will test something else. Okay, let me go and test, let's say, eBay, right? Okay. All right, so let's say you have been hired by eBay, and they say that, okay, they are coming up with a new version of their website, and then they want you to create some Selenium testing. So, first thing first, I have to go and create a manual test case. So in the manual test case, what do we have to do? We have to, this is the objective. Objective is, so, to test the search functionality of eBay, right? So that's my goal, objective. Now, my test steps to do it would be, one, open the browser, open Firefox browser, right, and navigate to ebay.com. Okay, number two. In here, in the search box, let's say I am searching for, what do you want to search for? You want to search for, let's say, Winter Olympic Games tickets in Russia. I think that's where the Winter Olympics are happening. So you enter a search criteria, whatever you want to, right? It can be Samsung 60-inch TV, right? So whatever it is, and then you click on that, and it will show you so many things. What 871 results from this. Now I want to capture. We want to see if eBay has this, right? So this is the word you search, and it came back with this many results. So I have to capture that. Yes, eBay has this many, right? What else do you want to? Let's say I want to search for Obama biography. Right? I don't know if somebody has. So there are 202 results for that. Right? So the idea here is, if the website is working fine, you will find something in there, right? So if the website is not working fine, it might give you zero results for everything. So, or it might give you minus something, or, you know, so we want to do automation of that. So manual testing is already done for this, so we have to do the automation. So I have to enter some text. So I would say, enter search text in the box, right? And if I have to, I can select the categories. In the first test, I won't do that. So I would just say click on the search button. Click on the search button. And final step is capture the results displayed. Capture the results. So these are the steps. So now I have to take this and I have to convert this into, I have to put this here. This is what I have to write my script. So once I put this over here, I got so all this red thing. That means that Eclipse is saying, what is all this? I don't understand. Of course, this is English. This is English. Eclipse will not understand English. What will Eclipse understand? Eclipse will understand some coding language like Java. So is this Java? No, this is English. So this English is for you and me. So we have to say to Eclipse that, okay, you don't worry about it. So we will comment. Put two forward slashes. It will treat it as a comment, meaning that keep it there so that a human can read it, but you don't read it. You don't worry about it. You treat it as a comment. Okay, so all green, that means that these are comments. Now, the question here is, how do I write the code to open the browser and to navigate to eBay? How do I write that code? How do I write that code to search for that box? How do I write the code to click on the search button? How do I write the code to capture this? How do I do that? So basically what you do is, in programming, you do all that, even though you have 20 steps, you write all those 20 steps, but you put them into something called a function. So when you write the code, these are called single, each is a single step, but all those steps would be put in a function. So how do you create a function, and where do you create a function? So in Eclipse, what happens is you will have to create a project. You would have to create a class. When it comes to creating a code or script, right, this code and script are created in what is called the functions. So we have to go and we have to create some functions. So how do we create the functions? Now, what I am going to do is, I'll say that, oh, I don't know how to do all of these things, and I cannot be learning in this one day. So is there an easier way? I want to get the job done. Is there an easier way? Now, you would say that there should be something. Oh, here it is. Who? Your friend. Who friend? IDE. Now, IDE can do the recording. So let's close this. Let's go in here, right? Go to eBay main page, right? This is where we were, right? Now, let us do the recording of it. So I go to Tools, and I go to Selenium IDE. So this is the Selenium IDE. Where am I going? I'm going to eBay. So I'll say eBay.com. You go to eBay.com. And this is some, save this as, save test case as, right? And we will call it test case for eBay search. Search test, right? So eBay search test. This is already recording. Now let us go and record. What do I have to go in here? I have to go in and then type. Let's say I am looking for, I don't know. I want to go to, in fact, I was there a couple of months back. Let's go to Vatican City to see the Pope. Right, so I would say Vatican City tickets, right? So I put something in there, right? Now I will click on this search, right? Now notice zero results found for the ticket. I want to make sure that how many tickets, what is there. So I want to capture this. So I highlight it, right click on that, and do what? I want to capture it, right? So capturing is storing. So when you want to store something, I give you a candy and I tell you to eat after 6 months. So you have to put it somewhere, right? If you keep it outside, you know, there's a possibility of you losing it. Somebody might eat it. So you want to keep it, store it someplace. So you put it in some container, or in programming, it is called a variable. So you store. You store text in a variable. So when I say click store text, now you would say there is a store text here, there is a store element here. So which one am I supposed to? So go with store text. So when you say store text, when you click on that, it says give me the name of the variable. So I will say that this is eBay results. So this is the name of the variable. In that, it will store it. So it automatically did everything. Now let me go back into here and see what it did, and let me stop it. Right? So here is my here are my instructions here. Now let me just go to Yahoo, right? And now let me just run this and see if it works. Let me do a slow and run it and see. There it is, right? So it clicked on that. And it hopefully types Vatican City ticket, clicks on the search, and then it collected that. So that's a test pass. So now my test is working. I can come in here and change this to, rather than saying Vatican City, I would say that, what do I want to put in here? So I would say that, Disney World. Right? Disney World tickets. Right? And if I run it now, if you see, let's say we were someplace else. We were like in TrainingRite website, right? So then I just want to run this. So it should take me to eBay. Here it is. I'm at eBay. It should type Disney World tickets, right? And it should, there are 445 results, so it should capture that in this store text. And since it is green, that means that everything is good. But I am not interested in the IDE. What I am interested in is how I can do this one, how I can do it here. So rather than me going and writing every line of code, what I will do is I will do some cheating here. How can I cheat? If I have whatever I wanted to do, I did it in IDE. Let us ask IDE to give me the code. How do you ask IDE to give you the code? You will go into options and you go into format. If you don't see all of this here, if you don't see all of this here, that means that there is something wrong in your settings. It might be something like this. Like if I go into options, if I do that, see, I'm not seeing anything in here. Because your setting is, if you go into options, this enable experimental is not checked. So this must be checked. Click on that. Now you come in here and do that. Now you want the code. Code for what? Do you want a C# code? No, I don't want C# code because Eclipse, inside Eclipse, we want to put Java code. Okay, I don't want Python. I don't want Ruby. I want Java. But which Java do I want? RC, remote control, or web driver, or which one I want? Okay. So let's say for time being, I will say that I want the web driver. But again, there is something called JUnit web driver. And there is a TestNG and all that. Right? So, okay, that's fine. I will take, for now, JUnit, I will say that. It says that you are trying to change the format. Are you sure you want to do that? Yes. And lo and behold, what you have here is so much of code. So much of code that is needed. See that code? So much of code that is needed. Now, because it is converting, you have a lot of code in here that it is converting. And then you can literally take this, copy paste the whole code, bring it here, right? And replace the whole thing with that code, right? So that's the code now. And there will be some modifications that you have to do, but then it will work now. There is some modifications you have to do, but it will work. What modifications you have to work? Wherever there is this red squiggly line, you have to pay attention to that. So this is saying that it's a package, example.test. Now, if you see package, I see default package here. It is saying example because we copy pasted it. So some discrepancy will be there. So when you bring your mouse onto this red line, hover over it, it will say how to fix it. Now, majority of the times, the solution they are giving will work, but, you know, it's not like 100%. In this case, let us see what it is trying to tell us. It is saying there are two quick fixes to resolve this. One is you will move this hotel reservation to package example.test, meaning that, see this hotel reservation? It will move it inside it. The other one is remove the package.com, which is this test.com. So what we got to do is remove package declaration, package.com. So if you click on that, it just removed it because there's already a package here. So there was an extra one. So it removed it. So that fixed the problem. Now let us come to this. There's a squiggly line here. Let us come to this squiggly line. Hover over it, right? There it is. Now, it is too small for us to see it. It is showing, but it is too small. So if you see here, it is too small. So basically, what it is, when you say public class, and this is the name of the class, and here we are calling it hotel reservation test. So this is different and this is different. So you have to rename it. You have to rename it like this hotel reservation test. So what I will do is I will just rename it as hotel reservation test. Okay, so once you do that, now everything is good. If I save, I have no errors now. All the errors went away, no squiggly lines, no nothing. Now, you would say that would I ever know about this, how to write this and all that? Now the answer is, when you go for certain things, like when you go for copy paste, it will produce a lot of unnecessary code. There's no need for all of this. If we are going to write this code, which we will start to write starting from the next class, this will be hardly be 5 lines or 7 lines. Because we copy pasted, it did so many things for us because we copy pasted, right? So if we had to write, probably it is like the most like 10 lines, not more than that, right? Okay, so now we have copy pasted. Now let us see if it will do what we want it to do. So I will just close the browser and I will what I will do now is I will try to run this code. How do you run it? If you see here, there's a green button here. When you click on that, now let us see what it is going to do. So now it is going to basically start a Firefox, and then it will go to eBay, and then it will do whatever we are supposed to do. There it is. So it is connecting now. It is going to eBay, and it will type that Disney World tickets, and it will click on that, and then you have a green line here. That means that the whole test is a pass. Now you would say that I have absolutely no clue what happened here. And I'll say that that's fine. That's fine. And because as long as you follow that, today we learned everything about what Eclipse is all about, where to download it, how to install it, how to create a project, and how to basically create a class. And we also looked into creating code or script inside the class. So we did not create, we copied the code or script inside the class, and then we ran it successfully. There were some issues, some red squiggly lines, and we took care of that. And we were eventually able to run it. And as you notice, it gave you this green. So in the next class, I will be taking all of this right out, and I will be showing you right from the beginning as how to write the code. Step by step, I will show you as how to write the code. Now, in order for me to show you how to write the code, we have to learn Java. So the next class will be about Java. So this is what I would want you to do. When you come to the next class, before coming to the next class, you must be watching the videos. If you have time, watch the videos, this video. One second, Selenium, any batch you take, the Java introduction, so you have to watch that. So let's say October 2013, okay. Usually like day 2 or day 3 I will do the Java, so this probably is the Java class. So let us see.
We will start our Eclipse, and then we will be going and creating a new project.
So let us see what it is about.
I will type at a time. So let's talk about this.
So probably this is sometimes what I do is I cover Java first and then introduce you to Eclipse. So that probably would have been the case here. So day 2, you would Java. Right, so just take a look, Java. Right, okay, so now let me, this is the assignment for you. I want to see this green here, and I want to, you give me the screenshot of this. You give me the screenshot of this, and I want to see a green here. And once you send, this is your day 2 assignment. So what What does this show as far as you are learning? It shows that you were not only successful in downloading Eclipse, installing Eclipse, but you have already know as how to create a project, how to create this class, how to create and copy paste this code, and I should be seeing this green line. That means that you ran it and then you see a green line there, right? So that's basically your assignment. Now, before we leave, let me ask you if you guys have any questions or anything. Let me just, okay. So I don't see any questions in here. So now you understood what's the assignment. The assignment is to download and to install and to copy paste the code from there, from here. So this would also, you would have known everything, right? You would have known this, that you have to check the experimental features. You would have known as how to export it, and I want the JUnit web driver. So you would have, and then you, and I don't expect you to know any word from this. That's fine. That's fine. We are still in the early stages. There's no problem if you don't know. So you should be able to do that. Okay. That's about it for today. If you don't have any questions, I'll let you go, and then we will meet again coming Monday. Now, coming Monday is definitely, the first assignment is definitely due by coming Monday. So if there is anyone who would have not completed day one assignment by Monday, I would be a little bit unhappy with that situation. So, because you have 1 week to complete the assignment, so you should complete the assignment. So better if you do sooner rather than later. So if you have any issues, post your questions in the Google group, and you should be getting some answers from the guys who have done these courses prior to you, or even your same batch people will be helping you. But do the assignments. And the first 2-3 assignments will be very easy. Starting from day 4 onwards, it will become a little bit challenging. And that's when you should not be catching up by that time. So you should have been done with all the first 3 assignments, so that when it starts to get a little bit difficult, you know, you should be able to put in some more time into it, right? So that's what you should do. Okay, so if you don't have any questions, I'll let you go. This is second class we just finished. So you know the assignment, and I'll see you on next Monday. And until then, take good care of yourself, and have a good night.